We are going to discuss about the revisions kit of the digital business strategy, that is BL8 of the business level 2 subject. So I think you may have seen the, some of the videos we have uploaded in the YouTube that has given so many information about the for you to study BL8 subject. With those videos, I think you may have gathered kind of a good knowledge, and with that knowledge, I think that is it will be very easy for you to continue this revision session. So from today onward, so we will be having around 10 to 11 sessions of this digital business strategy. So in this sessions, what I am going to teach is, I am teaching the subject contents and also the revision packs questions, and also some of the question I have gathered, I have created. So those questions, what I am going to express you today, that will give a very good understanding for you to sit for the examination. So let's start with the first slide. Syllabus area. So I know that you already you are aware about the syllabus areas that has 11 chapters. Business management, process and technology, managing technology in the organization, digitalization of business and e-commerce. And there are part B, C and D. So I am not going to explain these things. So already you are aware of these things. And you can see that part A, introduction to business strategy and technology 20%. Managing information in business 25%. Nature of scope of business, that is part C, 30%. Marketing strategies in the digital 20%. Actually, for this area, part C, introduction to e-business, e-business environment, e-business application, they have provided 30%. It means if we divide the question into four parts, 30% of the question will come from this one, right? And also this area is 20%, and this is a very common area, the strategic element will be talked about. And this area is the ERP and the role of information system in business. So this role of information system in business is a very big chapter. There are so many contents. And this last one is the marketing strategy in the digital, that is 20%. So let's start with the first one, that is business management process and technology. Business management process and technology. Okay. Here we are going to talk about what is strategy. Have you seen this word earlier? It's a common word. You may have faced in your organization when you are working also. Some of the student in CSE Lanka, they are still working in some of the audit firms also. So there can be so many strategies. It's a kind of, it's like this. First of all, we have to identify where are we. It is in an organization, where are we stand for, and where are we now. And this is where are we going to be. Let's say within 5 years of duration, you want to be a one of the best company in Sri Lanka. in order to achieve that, this is how are we going to get there. This is the action of things that we are going to establish in our organization to go to this stage, right? So, what is a strategy? It's a long-term direction of an organization. What does mean long-term direction? If it is 1 year period, no, that's not relevant. If it is a 5 year period of, if it is a 5 year period that you are going to plan, that can be a strategic planning that you are going to establish in the organization within 5 years duration. So, it talk about 5 years duration, a minimum of 5 years duration. If you have done some kind of strategic plan in your organization, you may have seen that. If your organization you are dealing with, if you can find out the strategic plan, if they have, that of course will have minimum of 5 years duration of the plan. And why they want a long term direction? Long term period, long term direction. It is to achieve the objective, not for a 1 year period, not for a 2 year period, it's a five year period. Normally, most of the organization, when they are going to plan the strategic planning, they initiated those things for a long term duration with long term directions. What are those long term directions? It means you will have to take different actions to achieve the objectives. So in here you can see one question I have given, it's a common one. What is the most correct statement relating to the strategy? In the examination also, sometimes they will be asking, what is the most correct statement relating to strategy? There can be so many. It's a course of action, including the specification of resources required to achieve a specific objective. There are special two things. There's a course of action. It means today we are going to establish a strategy to achieve some objectives. So objective will be achieving in a 5 years time, but you have to have so many actions, so many strategies to achieve that. And also not only that, you must have resources to achieve the specific objective. There are course of action and resources and objectives. Those are the three things. So you have to remember, in the examination also, sometimes they will be questioning about what are the three things of the strategic management. So you can say that course of action, resource required and specific objectives. Those are the three things that we are going to achieve. Especially I have seen some of the questions, they have directly asked about, it's a course of action including the specification of resources required to achieve a specific objective. And also it's a long term direction of an organization. It's not for a short term, it's for a long term. Strategic directions. Here you can see strategic direction, strategic decisions, successful strategy. If you want to make a successful strategy to achieve some objectives within the duration, let's say it's 5 years. So you are going to achieve some objectives. So to do that, you should have strategic directions and also strategic decision. In your childhood also, you may have practically seen this one. When you want to pass some examination, that's the target you have, that's the objective of you. You want to pass the O-level examination or grade 5 examination. So there can be some people who will give the directions. Who are they? Your mother, parents, they will give the directions. So they will give strategic direction. So you have to study 2 hours per day, and also you have to do mathematics well, and you are very weak in that, and there are so many things. Then you are given those directions. Your ultimate objective is to pass the A-level examination. So you have to pass the grade 5 level, and also then they have to pass the O-level and then the A-level. So your parents have given so many directions for you to achieve the objective, that is what, advanced level examination pass. And there can be strategic decisions. The strategic decision is, let's say if you pass the O-level, what you have to do? You have to select, if you pass the grade 5 scholarship examination, you will be transferred to some other good schools. Then it means your parents will have taken strategic decisions. So when it is going on to achieve the objectives, your parents may have taken decision that okay, we will put you to another school for further studies. Then when it comes to O-level, you are passing O-levels, then you are going to decide what are the subject that you are going to, what are the streams that you are going to do in advanced level. Then your parents will give strategic direction, okay Buddha, you is better if you can do advanced level in commerce stream or art stream, mathematics or science. So that direction will be given by your parents. If your parents is not knowledgeable, so they will consult somebody else and get the direction for you. And also that decision will be taken by you as well as sometimes by your parents. And we have taken all of these decisions to achieve what? Achieve the objective. Okay, in the board that I will explain it in a way that you can see that clearly. So you are here. Let's say this organization, right? We take an example, CA Sri Lanka, right? And there you are, you want to achieve what? The best chartered accountants in Sri Lanka. Already I think it is achieved, because you are the best in the CA Sri Lanka is the best in the in Sri Lanka. And let's say that you are not in that level. So CA Sri Lanka is going to achieve this objective. Let's say it's long term direction that will give you your CA Sri Lanka council members takes long term direction, and also decisions, they will take decisions. So they will direct you, they will direct the CA Sri Lanka managerial staff to achieve this objective. In order to achieve that objective, there is a special thing you have to do, that is strategic plan. The strategic plan which we are going to establish is for what? Achieving the objective, the best CA in Sri Lanka. In here there are so many divisions. Let's say exam division, registration division, member relation, marketing, IT. So, in order to achieve these objectives, let's say within 5 years duration, let's say we say 5 years, within 5 years duration, you are going to achieve this objective with CNC Lanka, and this will have, let's say today you have the member chartered accountant membership of 7000, which say you want to achieve it to 10000 or let's say 15000, and also student registration if it is 10000. Now after 5 years time you want to achieve 18000. So there are so many activities, the action you have to take. So exam division will have to have so many examination per year. Let's say normally you are having about 2 examination per level. So in here there can be so many actions you will be taking in divisional level. So divisional level also there should be a strategic plan, there should be a strategic direction, there should be a strategic decision taken in this all of these divisions to achieve that objective. And in the registration division also, let's say they are going to get the student number of 18000. So there are so many actions they have to do. As the divisional head, they will have to take decisions and directions. They have to direct their subordinate to achieve that objectives. Council will direct the division heads and also the head of the institute to achieve that objective. In the member relation, they know that they want to achieve that kind of that type that amount of student member numbers. It means now you have 7000 members, after 5 years time you want to have 15000 of membership. And the marketing division also, oh, they know that they want to achieve that number of students, they have to market, they have to brand. Then the IT division knows there are so many development going on, so they also have to do so many IT activities to embed in this process to achieve those objectives. So there are divisional level actions, call this action. There are so many actions here. So those has to be implemented in divisional level, ultimately you will be achieving that goal. So that is the strategic planning. So there are strategic directions, there are strategic decisions. So I think from this you may have received a very good understanding about the what the strategic plan, what's the strategic decision, what's the strategic direction, and how it should be achieved, and those kind of things you may be aware of now. Okay, in the question paper, some of the question I have taken from the revision kit, and also the question that I also have created. So you can see in this question, first question, they will be asking what is a strategy. Here, do you remember that we talk about what is a strategy? In here, it's a course of action including the specification of resources required to achieve a specific objectives. So it is directly given, the same wording has been given in here. Marketing and sales interaction with external parties, these are the wrong answers. So I am not going to explain these wrong answers because it will take time. So after doing these sessions, revision session, you can watch these videos, and thereafter you can take the revision kit, and also there are some mock examination answers questions also. You can write paper, you can answer for the paper alone, then you can see how you have progress. That is, what is the strategy? So answer is that course of action including the specification of resources required to achieve a specific objective. Which strategy is about how to complete successfully in particular market? What is the strategy that is dealing with this? That is business level strategy. In this question, you have to be concerned on which strategy is about how to compete successfully. That is the competition. How do you compete in the market successfully? That is where the business come from. In the next slide, that we will be explaining some of the details as well. There are business level, corporate level is there, and operational level. There are three levels in the organization. Let's say business level is there, the corporate level there, there is a top management, and also there can be business level, it's the divisional level, and then the operational level. So the competition, that will come to whom? Is it for the operational? No. Is it for the corporate level? No. That is for the business level. So this is the answer for that. I think it's clear to you now. An organization's general expression of its overall purpose is known as its mission. What is the mission is? You have a vision of CAC Lanka. I'm not going to explain in detail about the vision and missions, because as a student of CAC Lanka, you may be working in some organization, or else you may have read and understand about what the vision and mission. You also should have a vision, and also how mission. Mission is how do you achieve that. Vision is where you want to be. So in an organization also, a general expression of its overall purpose is known as its mission. Strategy involves. So strategies involve for whom? Senior managers and board members, managers at all levels. So this is the answer. Managers all, when you look at these answers, it will give a very clear understanding you what the correct answer is. So managers at all level, all the managers in the organization, they want to have strategies. So as I said you, in the divisional level also, there are so many heads of the division. They want to achieve their objective in division wise, then ultimately you will be achieving the main strategic objectives of the organization. So managers at all levels, let's say they can be in corporate level, the top level, can be in business level, and also in the operational level, they have to achieve some targets, they have to achieve some objectives that was given by the organization to achieve. So you are going to achieve those objectives. They are the managers at all levels. What is a policy? So what is a policy and strategy? So you will come to a conclusion that, is it a policy also same as the strategy? No. let's say in an organization, there can be so many strategies. Let's say in the HR division, there are so many policies and policy procedures. So there are strategies that they want to give a very good services to the people in the organization within 5 years time. They want to streamline all the processes they have, what they are currently doing, into policies and procedures. So you will make, if you are HR manager, you will make a policy of, let's say HR policy. That HR policy will have all the information about the rules and regulation of the institute. Then you are aware of that, and it's a part of the strategy of HR division. In the board that I will explain this. In the HR division, let's say IT division. So they want to achieve some objectives. So in order to achieve their objectives, what you are going to do is, you are doing so many reportings. Let's say you are going to do HR policy. You want to have a very good HR policy to achieve that one. And also you will have some other attendance policy. Inside this HR policy, and there are some other details as well. In this IT, so there can be IT policy. In this IT policy, email policy will be there, how to send the emails. And the marketing division, they will have what type of policies? They will have brand policy. How do you brand? So in the organization, you are going to develop policies and procedures in order to support the strategy. So these things will support strategy of the organization. So you may have so many strategies. To achieve this objective, in order to achieve these strategies, you have so many policies. So when you have those policies, you have a very good clear understanding in the organization. Okay, I want to follow this policy, email policy, brand policy, and HR policy. If you want to refer to some information about HR division activity, you can refer to this HR policies. If you want to get some information about leaves, you have to refer to the policies. So at the initial stage, you didn't have those, but now you have developed those policies. So I think it's clear for you what the policies and strategies are. So answer is guidance regarding the way in which an organization will seek to behave in relation to its stakeholders. In the organization, there are stakeholders. That's a guidance regarding the way in which an organization will seek. It's a guidance that will be given in the policy. So when you read other answers, it will be very creative. And also I have seen most of the answers given in these questions. In the revision kit also, we are very long answers. They have taken the whole answer into this. You can notice that when you are doing that. Strategic decision making. So you are going to take strategic decision. How are you going to take strategic decision? When you are going to do strategic decision making, the long term directions are there. So there are long term directions. As I said you, it's not for a 1 year period, that can be for a minimum of 5 year or 10 year. Likewise, you can have a very long year period of strategic plan. So some of the organization I have seen, they have 50 years of plan. After 50 years of duration, you are going to achieve this kind of a level in the current organization. And in order to achieve that, they have segregated, they have divided those plan into 10 categories at the year 5, year 10, year 15, likewise up to year 50, they have given so many strategies to achieve. And that's a long term direction. In the organization, as the senior managers, they have to take long term direction in the organization. In the CSE Lanka, council members and also the divisional heads, they will take the direction action. They will instruct how to do, what to do. And competitive advantage. When you are doing the strategy decision, so you are going to decide what to do. In your accountancy exam also, you are going to do, am I going to be a chartered accountant? What is the decision I have to take? Likewise, there are strategic decision you have to take. In the competitive market, there can be so many competitive advantages. Let's say if you are a first mover, it means if you are the first person who have launching the products, so you will have very good competitive advantages in the market. So when you are launching some product into the market, you are going to decide what kind of competitive advantages we will be getting in the competitive market. There are so many other people who are putting their product into the market. So there is a huge competition. So are you going to compete with the advantages you have with your product? So you have to decide. Scope of activities. When doing the strategy decision, there can be so many activities that you have to do. You have to note down all the activities in a plan. This is how you are going to do. Those are the scope of activities. So when you are taking the strategy decision, make use of unique resources and core competencies. So you have to take unique resources. There are so many resources in your organization. And you have core competencies. Oh, for each of the resources, you have core competencies. Let's say in your organization, you may have very good staff. It's a unique resources. So they have different core competencies. And make use of these competencies to achieve some objectives. So you are taking decision based on these unique resources and also based on the core competencies organization have. And also when the in the division level, based on the staff who are working in the division, they may have core competencies and they are the unique resources based on their experience and knowledge. So you are going to decide, this is how we are going to plan our things in the division. Adapting to change in the business environment. So you are going to adapt to changes in the business environment. So when you go inside the business, there can be so many things that you have to change. You have to adapt to the environment. Let's say if you are dealing with manual processes, if all the organizations are going to be online now due to this COVID-19 situation, so you have to adapt to the change. And you have to accommodate those changes with your staff. Then you will be in the business environment, otherwise you will be withdrawn from the business environment if you are not going to adapt to the changes. So that is the decision that you are going to take in strategy decision making. Recognizing the value and expectation of major stakeholders. Before doing the strategy decision, you have to identify what are the expectation of stakeholders. So there can be so many stakeholders in your organization. Let's say CSE Sri Lanka, student who are studying like you are the stakeholders, and there can be some members, they are the stakeholders, and you have to recognize the value, how important, and also the expectation of them when you are taking strategic decision. So you have to identify who are the stakeholders well, and then you have to launch your product in the market. That is how you are going to build the product in and put into the market. So that is the decision that you are taking. You have to evaluate and recognize the value and expectation of major stakeholders. If you are not dealing with that, ultimately, okay, major stakeholders, they will look at your organization, they see this is not what we expect, they are doing something else that is not required for us. So we will change our connection, the relationship with another organization. So they will do that, they will withdraw from us. Characteristic of strategic decisions. So there can be some question I will be given in the next slide based on this the details I have given to you. Characteristics of strategic decisions. What are the characteristics? When taking strategic decisions, there can be some characteristics. Those are like complexity. When you are taking some decision in your private life also, there can be some complexity. After all the way, you may have decided to do commerce subject. Why you have decided? Was there a complexity in you? Your parent will tell you, okay, you do the science subject, you do mathematics, and so many people may guide, if you do mathematics, you can be like this. If you do commerce, you can be a chartered accountant, and if you do science, you can be a doctor. Like guys, there are so many things they may have told you. So there's a complexity will come to you. So in the business also, when you are taking decisions, there can be so many complex problems will come into mind. That is, when you launch a product, will that be successful, and how do you define the prices of the products, and how do you maintain the quality of that? There are so many complexities which will come when you are taking decision. Let's say you are going to develop the best product in Sri Lanka, right? So when you want to do that one, that should have very good quality. In order to achieve the quality, so you have to spend a lot. So that's the decision that you are going to do. It's like a very complex thing, that if you are failing this product, what will happen? Your company will be at a loss. So there can be so many complex problems that you have to solve. Then those are the strategy decision you have to take. Uncertainty. In the business environment, it is uncertain. We cannot sure exactly this will happen. When you are launching the product, can you make sure that this will be achieving the market? Due to some disaster situation, let's say in the hotel industry, strategic decision, when you are planning the decisions, you may have planned it for 5-year duration, and you are going with this. After 2-year duration, suddenly the COVID-19 pandemic situation came across. So then what happened? It's an uncertain thing happened in the business environment. So you cannot achieve the target that is given to you. So the uncertainty in the environment is a very big problem in strategy decision making. Effect on business operations. So sometime when you are taking decisions, that is mainly effect on the business operations. If you are going to purchase new materials, sometime that materials that you put into the factory machines will not be accepted. So you have to take the decision. If you are changing the raw materials, you have to take the decision. So operations wise, that will be suitable or not. So you have to take the strategic decisions. So that is mainly effect on business operations. They affect the entire organization or business. Sometime when taking decisions, that will entirely affect for some organizations. As an example, I can tell there was an organization, it was in 2005 or somewhere. There was a software development company. They were very good in software development, and also they were good in infrastructure establishment, and they came into other business, that is selling PCs. They brought PCs from their profit that they have earned during the 5 years duration. So they spent all and brought those PCs to Sri Lanka to sell. Ultimately, they could not achieve the market that they want to achieve. It's a wrong strategy decision they have taken. Ultimately, the entire organization failed. So that will also can affect to any organization if they are not taking strategy decision well. Okay. So some of the question I have given you. So actually, I want to tell you that the strategic part. In the strategic part, there are about three sessions. So definitely, some of the question will come to the examination, because as per the study I did, the strategic questions that I am giving to you. Those question can be appeared in the exam paper sometimes. So when you are reading these things, let's say characteristics of the strategic decision, you have to think of in a way like how in the paper they will ask, how they will ask the questions. So you have to change your mind into that aspect. Then automatically you are in the path of creating questions for your own. So in here I have given some example questions. Which of the following are typically seen as being associated with strategic decision? When you are taking strategic decision, these are, what are the things associated? The organization long term direction. Yes, correct. I have explained you this earlier. So long term direction. See, the detailed planning of department work over the next month. It's like strategy decision thing. They are talking about the next month thing, like. The value of and expectation of powerful actors in the organization. So they are the stakeholders, you have to concern them. The scope of the organization's activities. So these three things are the answers. So when you look at that, in here they have given three answers. I think in your question paper only one answer will be given. So sometimes they will be asking about the three answers as well. normally they will be given the one answer in one question. One answer means there will be only one answer. You have to answer only one correct answer. There can be four answers, so you have to answer one correct answer. Strategic issue require which level of management decision? Strategic issues. If it is the strategic issues, then that is the top management decision. Let's say if you have 10 branches in your organization, so you are going to close down one branch. So it's up to the decision of the top manager. If you are an operational manager or if you are a business level manager, so you cannot take decision. You can give the facts to the head of the organization. Let's say in Sri Lanka for the council, we can give the details, the facts, then they will be take the decision of shutting down the branches. And if you want to open a new branch in somewhere, that decision also will be taken by top management. So you have to give the details to the top management to take the decisions. Strategic, the other question is strategic decisions ostensibly commit the firm for long term, typically 5 years. So as I said you earlier, it is for a 5 year period, not for a 1 year, not for a short term, not for a 3 to 4 years. It's a long time, typically 5 years period. So it's a simple questions. What is this? John Scholes, Winston suggests that there are how many general areas of decision making that are normally regarded as strategics. How many areas? There are 6 areas. Here you have to concern now. That is what it is given here. Okay. Strategic business unit. What is strategic business unit? SBU. SBU is something like let's say I'll read this out. Strategic business unit implies an independently managed divisions of a large company. So in the large companies, they may have strategic business unit. In CA Sri Lanka also, we can divide into member organization as strategic business units. They are the people who are dealing with the members, and they are getting some earning, some income for the division from the members, and also from the registration division. They are registering student, that's another business unit, and also examination division, they are conducting examination and they are earning some money, and that's also another strategic business unit. And also there can be the degree awarding division, that also a business unit, they also earn money from the courses. So there can be so many business unit in your organization. And having its own vision, mission and objective, as I explained in the previous slide and also in the board, the whiteboard. So I explained that how you are going to achieve the objectives. You have mission, you have vision and mission. So you know how to achieve the vision. You may have different actions. So accordingly, you are achieving the objective you are reaching the objectives. And characteristics of strategic business, what are the characteristics? Separate business or a grouping of similar business offering scope for autonomous planning. So there can be separate business, own set of competitors that may have each of the SBUs has own set of competitors. let's say if you are a car manufacturing company, so you are developing, there are business units called bike business, let's say electric car business unit, hybrid car business unit, petrol car business unit, diesel car business unit. So there are so many SBUs. So they all has own set of competitors. In those organizations, they are dealing with hybrid cars. There is a separate SBU, they are dealing with hybrid cars. So their competitors are hybrid car manufacturing companies. The other division is, the other SBU is the electric cars SBU. So then their competitors are electric cars manufacturing companies. Likewise, they have their own set of competitors. A manager who is accountable for strategy planning, profitability and performance of the division. So the manager of the division is responsible for that. So these are the similar things. It's very easy to understand if you memorize these things, separate business units or a grouping of similar businesses. It's like a group. And all set of competitors are there, and also there is a manager who is accountable for that. So in the question, this kind of simple question can be asked. What is an SBU? That is strategy business unit. Strategic levels. In earlier also I explained this one. Corporate strategy, business strategy, operation strategies. So there can be corporate level, business level and operational level in the organization. So you have to remember these things according to those two, three pillars. The one is corporate level, there are corporate strategies. In the business level, there are business strategies. In the operational level, there are operational strategies, and it is also called functional strategies. General level of strategy, in the corporate strategy, it's a general level of strategy that manage at corporate level. Yes, includes goal setting. So they are the people who are in the top management setting the goals. Decision relating to the structure of the group as a whole. So decisions are relating to the structure of the group as a whole. As a whole, they are taking decision. As a company, they are taking decision. As the institute, they are taking decisions. No direct contact with buyers or competitors in the any of its market. So they are in the top level. They don't want to deal with the customers. They want to deal with any other competitors. They are the people who are taking decision. So there is no requirement for that. Corporate strategy manages business SBUs and also add value to SBUs. So these corporate level coordinate with the SBU. They are the people who manage the SBU. They are the people who are manage the business strategies, business level people. What is business strategies? Strategy formulation at the divisional or SBU level. So strategies are formulated by the divisional heads in divisional or SBU level. Is the strategy for this product range and the market for the product range. So they are the people who are deciding on the what the product range should be in the market and how should be achieved. Likewise, those business decisions are taken by them. Manage at divisional level. In the each division, it is managing. So decide what market, what product to sell, how to target. So they are in the business environment. So they know how to market. They know what product should be launched to the market, whether it is will be successful or not. So they are the people who are taking those decisions. But this decision will be escalated to these corporate strategy for approval sometimes. Operational level strategies. Strategies plans or long term plans are prepared for each operation or function. For the each operation of the functions of the organization, these are plan. Strategy plans become successful if the strategies are effective at the operational level. Support the overall strategy. Actually, this operational level, let's say you are having three levels in your organization. That is the top level manager, that is the corporate level. The second one is the business level managers, the managers in the organization. They are the few people who manage. This is the operation level, co-workers, those who are working in the organization. Let's say here we have 10 number of people, here we have 30 number of people, here we have 200 of people, staff. Then if these people are not working, what will happen? The whole organization business is fail, will be fail. So this is the most important area of the organization. So when corporate level people are deciding on the decisions, they have to concern about this operational level the activities, then that will not be failing. And there is a link that I have given, I am not going to show this one now. So there can be some MC question that you can take from this link as well. Some question I have given to you, we look at that. Strategic management occurs at how many levels in large organization? How many levels in large organization? It's clear to you now, see, corporate, business, operations. So there are three. Corporate strategy deals with which of the following? The corporate strategy, this one. Overall purpose and scope of the organizations, this is the one that they are dealing with. So other things that I am not going to explain, you can see the other answers and get an understanding. So when you look at other answers, this answer will give a very good insight to you to select the correct answer. Different level of strategic decision making and a strategic formulation in any organization include what? Corporate, business and functional level. Functional level is also known as operational level. So they have mentioned other levels also, this is the correct one. So if you have very good understanding about this part, the strategy levels, you can write this answer, you can answer for this. Which of the following define how each individual business unit will attempt to achieve its mission? They are talking about business unit, it means business strategy. This is the answer. Which of the following define what business and businesses the firm is in or should be in? The answer is B, corporate level. They are the people who define that. What businesses and what businesses the firm is in? The organization is living in what business? In what business activities? So those decision has to be taken by whom? Can they take by operational functional level? No. In the business level, they also can't take. Only the corporate level can be take. Will take those decisions. Three horizon in long term strategy. What are these three horizons? This will mean a number of years which can be thought For three horizon, managers need to consider all these three formulating strategy. When formulating strategy, when we are designing the strategies, there can be thousands of strategies sometimes. In the government, when they came into actions after winning the government, they also had so many strategies. And likewise, in the managers side also, they also have so many strategies, they are going to formulate the strategies. So what are those three horizons? Meaning means defending and extending the current business. So you have to define what the business is and then extend the business, the current business, into some other business. Number two horizon, businesses are emerging activities that should provide new source of profit. So you will have, because of new businesses, you will have new source of profit, you will have new profit. Your market share goes up, then you will have a new source of profit. Horizon 3, ventures are new and risky and might provide return in several years time. So what you have established as per the plan, that will return in several years of time. Sometime as per your the strategic plan that you have developed in your organization, that may provide some returns that will give the achieve the objective within 10 years, 50 years, 20 years, likewise also. As a question, I have given this, that please note that I have given the question in a box like this, right? When you see this box, you can understand it's a questions. Long-term strategy is concerned with how many horizons? There are three horizons. So if you remember this horizon word, you will be remembering. You don't need to worry about these things, but if you remember only these three horizons are there, so you can answer for that. But I think the question paper, they will not be asking in this way only. They may be asking with the these content as well. What is digital business strategy? So we talk about business strategies, and there's a new word that is digital, that is called the IT, the technologies came into action. It's the application of digital technologies to business model to form new differentiating business capabilities. So now we are going to embed digital technologies. Now we are going to have new digital technologies to the business models that you have in your organization. To what? To form new differentiating business capabilities. So nowadays, because of pandemic situation, most of the organization have established their online platforms very well in order to supply the demand. So there is a high demand in the organization currently, that is for the online businesses. So the digital technologies came into action well in this situation, and so it means they are forming new differentiating the business capabilities. Now they have different business capabilities that they have developed using these digital technologies. So that is called digital business strategy. So sometime in the question paper, if they ask what the digital business strategy, so they will give this wording as one answer. There can be some other wordings as another answers. Information strategy. When you talk about information strategy, there are three strategies. That is information system strategy. That is where the systems are. In the organization, Infosys system strategy is supported by IT and IM. So these are the two other strategies that will support this IS strategy. So when it comes to information technology strategy, IT strategy, that talk about hardware and software. When information management strategy, that control and manage the information. So these are the people involvement who will control the manage information, and hardware software is required to implement the digital business strategies. And then information systems are there. So information systems are supported by IT and IM strategy. So in here the differentiation of these three categories, you can get an understanding about this is supported by these two. This is controlling and managing, this is providing hardware and software support, and this is the IS information system that provide a long term direction for the development of information system. Okay, so let's go to some questions. The scope of e-commerce is what? It's broad or narrow? In next slide that I will be explaining what is about e-commerce and e-business. So in here the answer is narrow. In that e-commerce is a part of digital business. So broader concept is digital business. The scope of e-commerce is narrower than digital business. So when you compare this digital business one and e-commerce one, so when you compare that, what is narrow, what is broad? Is this narrow? Is this narrow? No, this is small one, this is a large one, this is under this one. So the answer is narrow. So the scope of e-commerce is narrower than digital business. Digital business is now we will come the broader answer, because this is broader in its scope than e-commerce. So these two questions are given. The opposite of this is this. Digital business is broader in its scope than e-commerce. Information system strategy must address what? Quality of service delivery. Is it addressing infrastructure policy? No. None of the above. Select a future application for organization. The best answer is quality of service delivery. If you look at this one, here supported by AIMS for service delivery, they are supporting. Okay. How the technology add value to business? In your organization, how many ways that your processes has given so many inputs by the IT division, IT involvement. So technology has come into action now. Based on those value addition received from technology, your business is expanding. And that has given a very good image based on this technology. So how the technology add value to business? So we are talking about the value creation now. So technology has a value. If there is no value, we are not taking the technology into business. Because there is a value, they are taking this technology into business. So we will see how do we take that. In the operational level, the automated system, if the system are automated in the Toyota manufacturing company, Toyota car manufacturing company, most of the things are automated. The painting and the assembling of the cars, those things are automated. they don't use more humans interactions. They use automation meter system for operating. Then they can reduce the human resource cost, and also some other wastages can be minimized because of these automations. That is where the technology embed into the business operations. New products and services. For the new products and services, we involve the technology. Innovative product and services. So, because of technology, you can develop innovative product. You have to grasp the new technologies, and those based on those technologies that you have learned, you are going to build a new product or service to achieve the market. So, this is where you are embedding, you are getting involved with technology. Information, create knowledge, collect and store data. So, you have very good knowledge in your organization, within your staff, and also in the company levels, you have achieved so many knowledge, so much of knowledge. And you are collecting those information and store data. Let's say you have some system to gather knowledge, that can be knowledge management system, right? Using that knowledge management system, you have so much of data which is stored in the systems. So based on those data that is collected, then stored data, so you have the knowledge. Based on those information, you are creating some patterns of the market. What will be your market share? What is the strength of the organization? So that is where the IT, the technology involvement came into action and giving value to the business. Value chain. So what is called value chain? There are two words here. One is value, the second one is chain. You know what the chain is. It's a sequence of activities, a set of activities, and joined together, right? And that has a value. So, what is value chain? Is a set of activities that an organization operating to perform to deliver a valuable product. So, this is where you are. Why start in that? Then activity 1, activity 2, activity 3, activity 4. So there are different activities involved in this process to deliver the final product. So in these activities, there are different capabilities involved and providing value to each of these activities. These activities will be providing a value to this process. Ultimately, you are developing a valuable product. In order to develop a valuable product, set of activities are supported here. That is what we call value chain. Information technology transforms the value chain. The value chain models, which Mitchell Porter's devices, illustrate the way that a business had value for their customer through the 9 different activities. 5 primary and 4 support. We will see what are those. The value chain. So, in here, we talk about what is the value chain needs. There are different activities. So, let's talk about primary activities. There are 5 primary activities. Inbound logistic, operation, outbound logistic, marketing and sales, after sales services. But these 3 are the main activities in primary activities group, right? What is inbound? Inbound, that is into the organization. Outbound, from out of the organization, and operational level. So, in the value chain, in this inbound logistic, receiving, warehousing and inventory management, because of the technology involvement that add value to this inbound logistic. So, in the organization there can be so many logistic involvement. And in the operation level, the processes involved in turning raw materials and component into finished product. So, this is where the product is developed. So, in order to do that, there can be so many IT values, IT information technology involvement. And outbound logistics is distribution, including packaging, sorting and shipping. So, outbound logistics is involved here. So, after product is developed, so you are going to distribute that one, and packaging, sorting. So, if it is not distributed to the client at the correct time, they will not accept the product. So, what you have to do is, you have to send this product, distribute this product to the customer at the correct time. This is where the outbound logistics come in, right. So, these three are the main primary activities. So, what are the others? Marketing and sales, promotion, advertising and pricing strategy. So, they are taking different strategies. They have to decide the pricing, what the price that the market will accept, and what our price should be based on the cost of the manufacturing. You are going to decide what the price should be given to the customer, and promotion. So, you will be doing so many promotion activities, advertising, papers, newspapers and so many other magazines. So, this is where the marketing and sales came into action in value chain. So, value chain is, please remember, you have a product, you are going to develop a product, there are a set of activities, and ultimately you will be developing the product. In order to develop the products, you will have this kind of and also after developing, you have to sell it, and then after sales service. So, these are the after sales service. After the product is reached to the customer, you cannot get you free, because you have to service this. Sometimes for most of the product, you will be given at least 1 year warranty period. Within that warranty period, what you have to do? You have to give their best services. Installation, training, quality assurance, repairs and customer services, those are the after service that you give. So, all these things are included in the value chain. And secondary activities, there are four activities: procurement, the sourcing of raw materials, component, equipment and services. So, these are the activities you are doing in the procurement division, in the procurement division of the organization. They will be dealing with the raw materials supplying, and also component and equipment. There are so many other the materials that you have to purchase. So, this division is dealing with that. So, in there, they can have different systems for material handling and equipment purchasing. Purchasing system can be there, right. Technological development, this is where the IT, research and development, you should do research and development in this value chain. Without a research and development, you will not be getting very good innovative products, including product design. So, you have to design a good product, that is where you need the technology. And market research, you have to do so many market research to develop the product, and processes and development. So, technology development is a very good thing which give a very good value in this chain. This chain is a set of activities to develop a product. So, in this chain, this is a very valuable component, that is technological development. And human resources management, recruitment, when recruiting you may have systems, and hiring, training, development, and retention, and compensation and for employees. So, in this value chain, human resource involvement is a key thing, because without employees, you cannot handle this situation. All the things cannot be automated. If there are, let's say, you have automated everything in the factory, all those products are developed in automated systems, by automated system. Then you must have some kind of sales team and distributors team to deliver the product and also sell it to the people. And also you need people for managing. If those resources are not there, it's just a development. You cannot earn money by selling. Infrastructure, company overhead and management, including financial and planning. So, infrastructure development, in order to facilitate for this value chain, you must have a very good infrastructure established within your organization. Without the infrastructure, you are not going to, you will not be able to develop the product in your organization. So, that also give a very good value to the value chain. I think now the explanation I have given in this value chain picture. So, with that, I think we can proceed with the next slide that gives some example questions. What are those? What are the five primary activities of the value chain models? Inbound, operation, outbound, marketing and sales and services. This is the answer. You can see what is given there. Marketing and sales and services. Here, see these five. It is here. What are the supporting activities of the value chain model? Supporting activities, what are those? Out of these activities, other activities are here. Infrastructure of the firm, human resource development, technology development, procurement. Here you can see those four. They are talking about these four. Right? So, if you have taken a very good understanding about this explanation, you can write for these two simple questions. What are the activities performed in value chain? So, I explained this very well. Inbound logistic, inventory control system can be there, that is into the organization. Out to the organization is outbound logistic, into the organization is inbound logistic. Inventory control system can be there, and material requirement planning, that is where the materials are planned in the organization for next month, how many materials, how much material that we want to purchase, that is decided by this MRP systems which we have established in the organization. Enterprise resource planning, ERP, that is where which provide the very good support in handling the activities in the organization, so that give a very good value to the chain. Outbound logistic, warehouse management system control, warehouse operation, and radio frequency identification, ERP. What is radio frequency? RFID. So, in some of the organization, in factory environment also, that you may have seen in the supermarket, you may have seen this one, RFID is in some of the supermarket. You may have seen the barcode thing in the supermarket. When you purchase some product, you go to the cashier and put it there and they punch it, then they get the price into the system and bill. So, this also kind of activity, that radio frequency is there. You do not need to take it to the close of the equipment to scan. You can scan it with some short distance, and that will identify. In some of the companies, for attendance machines also, they have given some RFID card that has the magnetic field and that has radio frequency. When you punch that card, when you hang on that cart on the neck, then when you go inside, it automatically open, because it has a radio frequency that will be opened automatically when you go closer to the door. So likewise, those activities give a very good value addition that will save time in the factory environment also. The in certain products that you have developed, you can have RFID tags. Then using those RFID tags, that will be readable from the scanners, and automatically that will be packed to the that when you let's say that when you take the thousand of goods with the RFID tags, it is pasted in the products. So when you are loading into the lorry, it will automatically calculate how many products are loaded into the lorry. Using these RFID tags, those operations are actively happening. So that will save time. Operations, automation and efficiency. The operation level also, there can be so many softwares, ERP, AI, artificial intelligence, there are so many softwares that can accommodate their requirement. What are the active forms in value chain? There are some other activities that we explained here. Marketing and sales, a system can be there, online marketing, e-POS. In the e-POS is the POS machine, point of sale machine, electronic point of sale machine that you may have seen in the supermarket also. When you are selling the product, when the cashier is punching, that goes to a EPOS system. Services, system, so data to deal with customers. So there are systems and data to deal with the customers. And procurement, system used for procurement. For procurement also, they are using so many systems. So bidding document, the contract document, all these things can be online now. So e-procurement can be there. Using e-procurement systems, the company can establish a very good procurement system within the organization that the suppliers can attach to that. Human resource management, HR can be handled using the human resource management. So the other value addition in your organization in order to develop some certain product. In this organization, the Chartered Institute of Sri Lanka also, the final product is chartered accountants. In order to develop those chartered accountants, there are so many activities in the value chain, registration and sales and marketing and examination, procurement, human resources. There are so many activities involved in the chain. So that all of these activities has embedded with so many technologies involvement. There are so many systems involved. So those are adding value to the chain. The ultimately you are developing up good products, that is chartered accountant. Technology contributes to, let's talk about questions now, some of the questions. Technology contribute to business value in three main ways. What is one way? What are those three ways? Operational, business, likewise you know this. This operational one is here. Technology contributes significantly to value creation in how many main ways? Technology contributes significantly in value creation in how many ways? I explained this earlier. Here, see, these are the three main ways that provide value to the product development. So, answer is three. What is Michael Porter device? Here, Michael Porter, I have given here. The Michael Porter is talking about this value chain, right? When value chains come to your mind, remember that Michael Porter talk about that. He divides into 9 parts, that is 5 part is primary, 4 part is support. This is the 5 parts, this is the 4 part, right? Here, what is Michael Porter's device? The value chain. Value chain analysis can be used to what? Assess the impact of technology. Here, other answers are e-procurement, website initiative, extranet and intranet, the profit of an organization, value chain analysis can be used to what? Assess the impact of technology. This is where the technology involved. In all of these activities, technology involvement are discussed here. So, answer is assess the impact of technology. Research and development. In the organization, you may have research, you may have done research. As a student, as a university student or CSE Sri Lanka student, you may come across in research things. It means you may have to do some kind of researches. Before you do engage with this Chartered Accountancy Institute, you may have done so many researches. If you want to go in the field of accountancy, what is the best place to go with? That is CSE Sri Lanka. So, that is the research that you have done by evaluating so many other institutions and also so many other courses. So, that is called research and development. What is R&D? New innovations come through successful R&D and then it create competitive advantages and also provide value to the company. So, R&D is required for new innovations. If there are new innovation, the automatically company will be successful in reaching with, in dealing with the competitive market. So, if you have very good new innovation, you are creating competitive advantages in the market and provide the value to the company. It means you are doing researches, you have innovated new products. So, based on that product, you are taking the patent, now you are going to put into the market and that market have a very good competitive advantages for your company. Then company will have a very good value in the market. So, that is where R&D involved. Research and development, R&D can be which of the following? There is a question. An important source of innovation for companies. When there is a question with the R&D, if they ask what is R&D is, please remember that innovation word should come to your mind. Always with R&D, what they will ask is innovation. Through R&D, what we expect is innovations, new product and development. So, this is the answer for that. Stages in R&D, stages in research and development or type of researches. What are the stages? Stage 1, 2, 3. Number 1 is pure research. Number 2, applied research. Number 3, development. Pure research. What is this pure research? No commercial aspect or practical end. That has no commercial aspect. They don't need any commercial aspect. And not having a practical end. They wanted to the research on some kind of subject and they are doing it. And most of the time the government funded and does by universities because it will be very costly. And most of the universities are involved with that because of R&D, their rating also goes up. If it is a university, when they are doing R&D, research and development, because of their new innovated findings, their rating of the university also goes up. That is why they are funding for R&Ds. Government also funding for R&D. Does not produce marketable result. They don't need any marketable result. What they want to do is a creation of that. Creation of smartphone as an example, let's say before making the smartphone, there can be so many PO researchers involved in order to develop a speaker also. There can be so many researches that has been done previously, and also develop the screen of the smartphone and wireless gadget and keyboard, even the materials used for the keyboard, that also came with the R&D. And the R&D is not subject specific, it's a finding of theories, some advantages that can be taken to some products. Applied researchers has commercial aspect or practical end. So a special example is due to special medical research for coronavirus. They have taken developed a vaccine now. It came with R&D. It's an applied research. It apply for a subject, it apply for some issue, then they applied for a coronavirus issue, then they created the vaccine. So that came with applied research. Development, use the existing science and technology, produce new products. Existing science and technology used to develop new product, electric cars without need of charging. So these are kind of example that will come in future. If there is electric cars without need of charging, that will be a very good development. That development came through the applied research and also through PO researchers. Before doing the applied research, the PO researchers may have done, and based on those results. The PO applied research is applied to have a commercial aspect. Which of the following best describe PO research? What is the answer is? PO research is original research to obtain a new scientific or technical knowledge. Or understanding with no obvious commercial or practical lens. Here we talk about commercial practical lens is not there. When there is a question asked with poor research, firstly what should come into your mind? That is, there is no commercial practical lens. There is no requirement for the commercial aspect or practical lens. This has to be remembered. Then it is easy for you to find the answer. In the opposite one is applied research that has a commercial aspect or practical lens. Knowledge management. What is this knowledge management? What is the knowledge? You have knowledge in your mind. Maybe you are a 25 years old boy or girl. From your childhood, from year 1 to 25 years, you may have gathered some knowledge. Have you managed that knowledge? Yes, you have managed that knowledge to do some work. So you are gathering knowledge from me. So I am teaching you, you are gaining some knowledge. So you are managing that knowledge to sit for the examination. So what is knowledge management concept? The process of creating, sharing, using and managing. It's a process, please remember this, that is creating what? Knowledge. Sharing knowledge is creating knowledge, sharing knowledge, sharing with some people and using that knowledge. And managing that knowledge and information of an organization, not only knowledge, the information, right? In your organization that has so many informations, that can be stored in your systems, files or somewhere. Based on those information, you are summarizing is as a knowledge that will be learning by you. There are special knowledge management system in most of the organization. Knowledge management system is multidisciplinary approach to achieving organization objectives by making the best use of knowledge. By using the best use of knowledge, using the knowledge, they are taking multidisciplinary approaches to achieving the organization objective. In order to achieve the organization objectives, there are some knowledge available in your organization. You are taking multidisciplinary approaches to achieve the objective through that knowledge. Key factors in realizing and sustaining an organization's success. What are the key factors in realizing and sustaining an organization's success is considered here. Capture, organize and store knowledge for us by an organization and its staff or managers. So, the staff who are working in the organization is captured the knowledge and they are organizing a story. In the knowledge management concept, here what we call data is available, and collecting data and organizing those data and summarizing those data in this information layer. Data is not structured data, unstructured data is there. Then analyze, summarizing and analyzing is here. Here collecting and organizing, collect and then organization different subject. And summarizing those things and analyzing. And synthesizing and taking what is the output should be. And then taking the decision is the knowledge level. Knowledge management is a plan of action that outline how your organization will manage company information, data and knowledge to improve your productivity and efficiency. It's a plan of action. Actually, I have seen in some of the question in the question that available in the revision kit. They are directly talking about this plan of action. The one answer will be plan of action that outline how your organization will manage. A plan that manage and improve. In knowledge management, is a plan of action that will manage company information and data knowledge to improve the productivity and efficiency. So, in order to improve the productivity and efficiency, there is a knowledge. In the board, I will explain this. Knowledge management. This can be a system, right? A plan. This plan of activity. There can be so many activities here. And that will manage. So, knowledge is managed by this knowledge management system. That is for what? Productivity. So, this has the information and some data is there. In different forms, you may have information. So, that is managed by this knowledge management system that is managing. And there is a plan of activity, how do you plan that? So there are different activities that is planning here, and that activities are planned, and then that is for what? For efficiency, product delivery. So you may have collected so many information in your organization. Let's say during past 10 years of in the industry, there are so many data that you have collected. Let's say product A, product B. There can be different sales you have done, 10,000, 20,000, or likewise you have done. There is a history that you have managed in your organization that is stored in a knowledge management system, right? Then those informations are there. So what you are doing is those informations are managing by you, and you know what kind of action plan that you are going to do in order to make efficient product. If you are a newcomer to the industry, you don't have this information, right? Let's say past 5 years duration, you had so many products launched into the market. Those products had different prices and also different qualities, and it is subject to different subjects. So those informations are there. Now based on this information which is stored in the knowledge management system is captured by you and manage and plan to develop a new product. So you are going to develop a new product, and that can be developed very efficiently based on the knowledge you have. So knowledge you have is collected, and you are managing that to develop a new product. So I think it's clear to you now how the knowledge is managed based on the history of data you have to develop a new product or give some efficiency to the new product. So there can be a top down approach and bottom up approach. Top down approach is considers the overall strategy of the organization. The overall strategy is concerned is top down approach, while bottom up approach focuses on key business processes. So there are two approaches: the strategic plan, as per the strategic plan, the top management identifies the areas in which knowledge can be best exploited. Based on research into existing key business processes in order to determine important needs and issues. So, in the key business processes, the bottom up is used in the top management overall strategy. This is used. So, please divide this meaning into two. If it is top down approach, you have to remember that is overall strategy. If it is a bottom up approach, you are concerned about that's a business processes. Two meaning has to be divided by you and understand. Sometimes when questions ask, they will ask about this. The top down approach is dealing with overall strategy. So this will be the answer. Bottom up approach is focusing on key business processes. Then there can be some other answers as well. So if you are understanding this concept I explained to you, you can create some questions by yourself and then note it down in a piece of paper. For I am telling you one example. If you for each chapter, if you can create some questions. So when you look at this side, right? So, this is a concept that I talk about, knowledge management strategy. Under this, you can create as question as much as possible. You can write down the question I given to you, and also some question you can create. So, you may be aware that other than this, the question I have created, there will not be any other question will come to the examination. You can pretty sure that. So, from today onwards, please remember that you can take a piece of CR book and write down the question from each of the chapter. The ultimate, you will be having very good question bank with you. So, when you are facing for the examination, within 1 day or 2 day, you can capture the whole knowledge by using that question.